Hey, this is Drew the Geek. If you've caught my other video, cool. I am aware that the audio and video is off a little bit. I don't know why. I'm not entirely sure I know exactly how to fix it. I'm still new at this. There's probably some kind of weird stream setting or output setting or something that I have to change. I really honestly don't know how to fix that. So anyway, so I am aware that it is a little off, but well, it's a cheap video. What do you expect? All right. So fair warning: these videos are supposed to be 18 plus. I have done what I think I can to set that so. But just so you know, I cuss, I drink, I offend people, and I do all sorts of crap that you probably don't want little children listening to, so, you know, use headphones, be responsible, and, you know, or just don't watch my videos, because, you know, I'm not going to apologize for fucking cussing and being who I am, so that's just the way it is. So, anyway, these are War Thunder based videos. I suck at War Thunder, but it's a lot, I enjoy playing it. That's the bottom line. So, you know, that's what we're gonna do, and you get a little camera of me, so you can see me getting all pissed off and angry and red in the face and all sorts of shit, and you can see how many times I refill my glass with wine. I do believe that some of the audio issues that I had, this is me filling my glass. That's a tall one. Anyway, I do believe that some of the audio issues I had before are now fixed. That was an experience and a half. I ended up having, I actually have a, my audio set up. Some people are like, oh man, you sound like you're on the radio. Well, I work for an online radio station, KGRARadio.com. Yes, that's a shameless plug. Anyway, so, I don't usually do broadcast. I actually mostly handle their website, but I got into this audio stuff because I thought it was fun and I enjoy it. And it's kind of like a hobby thing. So I have a Motu Audio Express. I have a Behringer Procom something. I can't read that. It's a Pro XL something or other, but it's a compressor. I have a Tube MP preamp. I've got a Behringer microphone. There's a Behringer mixer board over here. It's got all sorts of cool special effects. But I have all that set up, so that's why I sound fucking awesome, at least to me. And so, you know, let's get on with it. Now, I think I explained, you know, there's the issue with repair. I have repairs. Let me show you a little bit crew. See this, I've got 33. That's crew level. Your crew level is based on how much training you put into these numbers, but honestly, I cannot for the life of me recall. I don't think that there is a... what am I thinking? I don't think that there is anything that I have found as of yet that actually explains how the crew levels are determined, but that does come into play mostly when you have these. Now, look, I was talking about this, I think, the other day, where you have these upgrade, these qualifications. Don't worry about it. Yes, it's going to give you these bonuses. You see, like, +3, +3, +3 to all those, but... when you're just starting out, I mean, dude, look at this, okay? Just so you know, you have all of these tanks to research, okay? Plus, you have all the U.S. tanks to research, okay? You have all the German tanks to research. You have all the Russian tanks to research, actually, I think that's more Soviet Union. And then you have the British tanks to research, okay? You've got the Japanese tanks to research, and then if you decide to go for planes, you have all the planes to research of each of those. So there's a lot, and they're expensive. They cost a lot of lions. So, you know, when you're starting out, spending extra money just to boost this, it doesn't make, I haven't seen where it makes that much of a difference to be worth it. It's just, I don't think it's really worth it. I don't think it's worth the time to go in there and spend that extra alliance. Because look at this, I'm at 53.7, you know, and I just bought something and I've been playing this, you know, today earlier. So, you know, like I said, you're better off just not worrying about it. But that being said, it is important to pay attention to these. Now, right now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these 263 crew XP points and I'm going to level up the repair rank. While that is not going to help me in the field, it's not going to help me defeat people, it is going to save me money. Because what happens is that, like I said, you know, I can bring this, if I close out of this and hit this button, you'll hear, see down here, it says 5139. If I just wait a little while, you'll see that number drop to, like, see there it went, 5138. So what's happening is that while these tanks are sitting on the field, or essentially, you know, see, look, you're basically at your base. Okay, here's your repair base. All right, and while you can't see it, although that would be kind of cool, wouldn't it? To see people actually working on your tank, that would be fucking awesome. But, you know, all these little things. But see people working on your tank. But so what's happening is your tank is being repaired over time. And right now, if you look at this little, you know, thing here, and I can't point to it with the mouse, but you'll notice that there's a max repair cost, and you see where it says time to repair for free. So in one day, if I waited for like 26 hours, okay, condition right now, it says I have 21 hours, 49 minutes. So if I waited until tomorrow, the tank would be repaired and I wouldn't have to pay anything for it. So if you're a casual player, you don't play a lot, this is a good way to go because you don't have to spend it. And look at that, it's 1,739. It doesn't seem like a lot, but if you play 5 or 6 games in a row, it adds up. So, you know, I think that it's worth it, you know, if you're trying to save a little bit of money. But there are other things in the crew that I've like found that are a lot more important. One of the things that I think is a real pain in the ass is if you look at the, if you go down, you look at this little card up here, you see turret rotation speed, vertical guidance, you see reloading rate, 7.2 second reloading rate. Okay. Now, that might not seem like a lot, but it's a long time when the other guys have like a 5 second reloading rate. So you hit someone, all right, and then you've got to move. You know, it's not like you can just keep unloading a boom, 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 boom. You've got a reloading rate. So in your crew, though, you have your tank loader. And right now I have my my level up to 2.5. And if I want to do it again, it's going to cost me another 310 points. But my weapon reloading now is down to 7.25 as opposed to 7.67. And it might not seem like a big deal, but you see there on the right there, it says top. Oops, sorry, I moved my mouse here. It says top. So if I max this out for this particular tank, it's going to be 5.9 seconds, which, you know, doesn't seem like a lot, but that's pretty damn fast, all right? So that's one of the things that, you know, it's important. The other thing is you have this thing called keen vision, okay? So basically, like, if you watched the other video, you saw how I zoomed in. Well, basically, when you increase this, it allows you to zoom in closer, but it also has, when you're looking in a certain direction, it's better. You can see, like, you remember that map in the lower right-hand corner? You're more likely to detect air targets. I've actually seen there's other types of battles where the tanks aren't marked, but you'll like see a tank and this little arrow will appear over it. So it definitely is important. Now, the one thing you have to remember, though, is you'll notice if you're watching, is that it's the average skill value. So it's not just the keen vision for this one person. It's the average of all the driver, the gunner, the tank commander, the tank loader, the radio operator. It's all of them. So you have to have them, you know, leveled up across the entire length there. So right now I have mine at 1.5. Field repair is the same thing. If you see me sitting in the field and I get damaged, there's, you know, now that like on this one, you know, the modifications, I have the parts. So once you've redone the parts, then you can repair in the field. So when you're in the field and you're not sitting in a space that you've captured, you can repair your tank. And, you know, that's useful, you know, because sometimes things go bad and you find you can't move the turret, can't move fast enough, or your tracks won't move. There's been a couple of times when I've had an entire track blown off and all I can do is go around in circles and feel silly, you know. So, you know, like the kid that says, Mommy, Mommy, why am I going around in circles? And Mom says, shut up, son, or I'll nail your other foot to the floor. So anyway, you know, that's important to get, but you don't want to be sitting out in the open. So that's why this field repair is important, because right now it doesn't seem like much, but 30 seconds, man, that's like a full half a minute. I mean, that's like dead time. You know, someone sees you sitting there repairing, man, you're toast. You know, so, but it goes down to 19.64 seconds, and it does change. Like, if I, like I said, these crews you can have for different tanks. You know, like, I'll show you here. I can actually go in here, and I can change a vehicle. Why do I not see? Because I've got aviation selected. Oops, let's change that. All right, there we go. So, see all these tanks here? All right, I can change to any one of these tanks with the same crew. I don't have to change a different crew. So now they're different ranks and stuff, and there's more complexity. And if I get another tank, when I get another tank in one of these videos, I'll show you how I, you know, what you do with the crew and all that. But like I said, you know, these things. So, all right, now that my ADD, me jumping around. So remember I said, you know, that qualification isn't worth it because of the money? Well, right now I am in the process of researching this Ostwind, okay? And this is mostly like an anti-aircraft tank, but I've seen it do some pretty nasty damage. But if you look down, let's see, first group, second group, third group, fourth group, you'll see the red numbers down there. 190,000 Lions plus 55,000 training costs. So that's like over 200,000. That's 245,000 if I'm adding correctly. Yes, I drink wine with a straw. Go fuck it. Anyway, so it's roughly 145,000, or I'm sorry, 245,000 that I have to have for that one tank. So that's what I'm saying. You know, every thousand Lions lasts. Now, one thing I don't think you've seen yet is that when you log in every day, you can get a reward, and that's what these are. Now, some of them are Lions, but right now I'm on a research one. I've got one more missions left. And this is just a temporary booster. It gives me an extra 30% to things. So now that I've been sitting here shooting the shit, see, I'm down to 5105. So, but that's okay because, see, actually earlier today I was playing while I was watching another video, another story. But anyway, I was playing today earlier, and I earned on one session, I actually managed to earn 21K. So, you know, I'm not too upset about spending 5K to clean up my mess. The one thing that did piss me off, though, is that one of the games I played, if you look at the crew, I'm at 293, and I want, oh, shit, that's right, that was the other one. Oh, damn, I forgot. See, I want to up leadership on this guy, because it's going to be too much to up these other ones, and so I'm going to wait a little while. Because I know it seems stupid, but when I do keen vision just for me, because I like things equal and even, and no, I don't have to turn a doorknob three times, but damn, I'm close to that. But, but so I want to wait until I have enough to level up my keen vision to the next across all of them. So you're talking 135. That's at least 1, 2, 3, 4. That's at least 500. And 60, it's going to be 600 something. I'm horrible with math. But anyway, so I want to upgrade the leadership because this actually gives an overall boost. Right now I'm at 4%. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take it up to 5%. I'm sorry. 5%. So here that, and now I'm at 5%. So every one of those skills you see there, is going to give me an extra 5%. Now, it doesn't give me, oh yeah, it does give me 5% in weapon reloading. So I can go over here now to this tank loader, and my top is still 5.9%, but I'm at 7.23 seconds. So I think that's pretty cool. I think that's pretty good. I think that's what that other one is. That 0.09 is the extra percentage that I get for the commander. So as you can see, that's pretty freaking awesome. All right, so moving on. All right, now I've wasted enough time. Let's repair. And instead of shooting the shit, let's go here. Now, you don't have to pick the tank that you want at the beginning of the battle, but You know, I'm thinking to myself, okay, this is what I think I want to play first. So, you know, I just do it ahead of time. Just the way I do it. And yay, I'm joining a random arcade battle.
Joining random arcade battles. Yay. Here I come to save the day.
Damn, what is it about these? All right, so I got another one of these. Defend the A point. Yeah, all right. So we're going to do, as soon as this loads, slowly but surely. Yay. Okay, so actually, I think now that I know it's this one, I'm going to change to the other one. That one, I've almost finished all the modifications on it. All right. So now, let's see. A point. The nice thing is, I have pretty low latency on my internet connection. Oh, there must have been a guy there that I couldn't see. My system's pretty fast. So a lot of times, when we start, I'll actually log in before a lot of other people do. Right now, it's really hard to see, but in the lower left-hand corner, you can see my frame rate, my ping rate. My ping rate's at 93, which is actually kind of sucks, which probably means I'm on a European server. But that's okay. Oh yeah, we're gonna come up here and see, you gotta be careful. Yeah, that's gonna happen. So they have. Damn. I bet you all three of them hit me at the same time. Woo-wee. All right. So now, I think what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to be a little sneaky. I'm not going to be able to come in the same way. See, these types of tanks, you notice that they don't have much of a turret, and they're supposed to be sort of like sniper tanks. You know, they're kind of long range. I need to work on some of the crew stats to make it a good long range weapon, but that's basically what it's for. So really with this one, I shouldn't be too close. I should find a good camping spot and just wait for something to come along and blow the fuck out of it. So that's what you're supposed to do. I hardly ever listen. But that's also why I suck at the game, because I really don't pay much attention to strategy a lot of times. I just kind of do whatever the fuck I feel like doing. But see, I've got a couple of other guys that have the same idea. You know, and that's good. Alright, let's see here. Let's see. Side in over here. One thing I noticed about steering is, depending on how you, don't hold it. Like, don't hold down the steering, just tap it. You know, tap a little left, tap a little right, you know, back and forth. Whoops, I accidentally hit that button. So just do a little bit of tapping on it. Because that way, you don't turn too much, and it's actually sometimes a lot easier when you're just trying to, you know, guide it down a straight line. So that's something to think about. If you're turning really tight, then yeah, that's, you know, you want to hold on it. But some people don't really talk about, you know, how to actually steer a tank. And I found that little tiny corrections are better than trying to hold it down, you know, that kind of thing. Just tap, tap, tap a little left, tap a little right, you know, whatever it needs. Whoops. Oh, shit, there's a tank over there. Damn. Two of them. Sitting there, motherfuckers. All right, I want to bring you out. Because I'm probably going to do really crappy on this one. Let's see now. Where do I want to go? All right. Oh, and in case you're wondering, this is the... Yeah, I'm using this mouse. So I've got extra, I don't know how well you can see that, but I've got extra buttons on the side, and then I've got, you know, buttons up top. So basically that allows me there, even though I have a flight stick that I can use, I can actually steer the entire tank with just one hand. And with this tank, actually, the only thing I need the flight stick for is because I have the repair and extinguisher keys bound to it. So I can actually just stick my hand down and not even play, except with just that one mouse. That's a Logitech gaming mouse, and I don't know, they're not cheap, but I think this one was like somewhere around $60 range. And I gotta tell you, like, I use it for so many other things. I'm going to go this way. I'm not paying attention where I'm driving here. I've used it for so many other things, because you can custom program it for different programs. I have an audio editor that I've, like, bound the keys to for the audio editor. I have this program called FreeTele, and I combine, like, stop and reverse and rewind and pause and, you know, use it like a little remote control, because FreeTele is for watching TV, basically, for free. Thus the name FreeTele. What am I doing here? I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. But anyway, so, you know, I have found it be very useful for other things and not just in games and stuff. Plane came in. Yeah, as you can see, there's no cover. I've always thought it was really cool how they actually put people here. Like, you can actually see the people in the tank, which I thought was kind of cool. Oops. Now, that's the only problem with using that middle mouse button you have on there. You can push it to the left for a button, you can push it to the right for a button, you can push it down for a button. I keep forgetting I can push it down for a button. So that's what I use to steer left and right, is I have those, I just tap a little to the left, tap a little to the right, you know. And of course, if you do a hard, you can actually do a little spin. See? Of course, now I'm going to wreck my tank. Ooh. Make a hole. You see the little round circle there? You notice that it has green. So that shows you the reload rate. The reload rate on this one is actually pretty good. I think it's around 5 seconds or so. So, oh, this is the goal. Just to come up behind here. Try to long-range shoot shit. I don't really see anything. I may have to...
Need backup.
I have to come here. See them over there. Damn.
No nerve piercing. Yes, a hit.
Good ass hit. That was a hard ass hit. Know exactly what he's doing. I think he might be toast. So you see the tracks? Got my tracks hit, so I'm doing this repair in game. So I can't move. Although all I can do is move in a circle. Now I can go. Let's see if he's still back here. I think they killed him. Yeah, he didn't survive. See, what this is now is what they're basically doing is we've won the spawn point, and because there's only one place where you can log in, everybody's jumping up on that, and so every time a tank spawns on the enemy base, we kill it. See, now we see that hostile team has lost all its vehicles. Boom. Done. Which, if you can get a group of people to do that, it's cool, but it's also why I kind of think that it would be fair if they always had two spawn points, you know, apart from each other, so that it would make it more difficult to do that. But, yeah, only made 5,465. Let's see. Suspension. Actually, I think I'm going to go for the filters, because it would get me a little bit more horsepower and a little bit more inclination, so that could actually help a little bit. I'll go with that next. I earned enough to actually research that entire thing. Okay. Let's research better bullets. That's basically what that is. Researching better bullets. And I have noticed, actually, I want to see if that repaired economics. Yeah. So when you get a modification, it looks like, I can't be entirely sure, but it appears that it repairs the vehicle automatically without you having to pay for it. So that's a good thing, because that actually means that this one was damaged. What? I thought I damaged the other one too. Oh, I did, but they both had modifications on it. Okay, so you see the wine's having to take effect. But this one to repair is only going to be 265 lions. But I'm going to be greedy. I'm not going to repair it. I'm going to wait and play another one, because it's fun that way. So, see, I'm not recording. I am live. So, I look at that. See, I'm looking at this, you can't see it, but on this other screen I have my recording software. So I can see exactly how long. I have been shooting the shit for about 27 minutes and 25 seconds. So, look, here we go. Here's one with three. So, you basically, the goal is to keep and hold three. Now, here's the thing, okay? Strategy-wise, you really need to keep and hold at least two of them. Like, you don't have to hold all three. You just have to hold more than they are, because the more you hold, the faster that red line drops. And the more tanks you kill, the faster that red line drops. So, really, the ultimate goal is to hold a minimum of two of those points. Ooh, ping pong! You know, sometimes I can understand, because, like, there's been a couple of times when I've run into someone because they simply didn't see them. Like, literally, they hadn't spawned in yet completely to the game, or my system hadn't registered that there was anything there, and all of a sudden they're in front of me, and I just couldn't stop fast enough. And I've seen that a lot. So, but other times people are just being assholes. Like, I even had one guy once try to push me over a cliff because I was in his way. See, there's that. Where is he? Where did he go? There he is. Oh, there's two of them out there. Oh, damn. See, that's why I need a better reload rate, because I was out in the open and I knew I could hit him. I knew I could come in there and do some damage to him if I could reload fast enough. I'm going back. I'm going to see if I can hit him from further away. Allied forces have captured the zone. So anyway, if you happen to be watching this video and you have any suggestions, comments, or ideas, feel free to do so. If you are actually interested in playing World War Thunder, go to drewthegeek.net And there's a game button up there, and there's a special link. It's a like an affiliate link or whatever. I mean, you could just go to War Thunder and download the damn game for free, but if you click on the link, I get credit for your click, and then if you decide to buy something premium, then, you know, I make some golden eagles, and, you know, and it'll make me happy. So that would just be cool if you did that. If you don't, you don't. I mean, I'm not gonna, you know, not gonna get all pissy. Do it. Go do it. Click on my special link. He is coming back in there. Oh, damn. It's just about to change tactics. Some of these guys are really fucking good at aiming. I gotta figure a new tactic. Let's see here. What I need to do. So maybe I need to take a longer road. Come at him from a different angle. Because out this way, he's not going to be able to see me as easy. So I might be able to flank him. Because the one thing about those that I know from just playing them is that their turret rotation speed is really slow. So if you can get right up on them, those CM-88 flak, whatever the fuck they're called, you can pretty much destroy them in a really short period of time. Because they're very vulnerable. You just have to get there. You just have to be able to come in on them. He tried to take me out. He realized he sucked at it. See, they're way over there. I'm way over here. See, I need to repair tear. Oh, fucker! Damn, man! You know, I blame alcohol. Really? So I'll just have more of it so I care less. So at this point, in all honesty, I mean, I'll probably think of other shit along the way, but I think I pretty much taught you everything I more or less know about War Thunder. That is your short commercial break. And actually, I was playing with myself and picking my nose behind the scenes. So, just so you know. Anyway, let's see. Did a repair. Now I'm just going to go right back to battle. Now, I can show you this here real quick. You can select your servers. So, like, if this is a Russia, I don't know what SA stands for. South America, I think. I think that's what that is. I'm not entirely sure, but, and the thing is that, remember that when you're connecting to a server across the ocean or further away from you, you're going to have higher latency. And so there's a good chance that, like, if the ping rate goes real low, that suddenly stuff will stutter. Like, you'll be driving down and suddenly there's an enemy tank in front of you and he's blowing the crap out of you and you didn't see him 3 seconds before. It's because of the latency. So try to pick one close to you. Now, I have played on EU servers before and I haven't really had a problem. So that's why I select them, because you're more likely to find, a battle of any kind. So, one of these days, I'm not going to do it right now. See, look, I lost. Anyway, one of these days, not anytime soon, though, is I'm probably going to do a couple of a realistic battle and then a simulator battle, just so people can see what they look like. Well, I can show you. Actually, you know what I can do real quick? Nah, I'm going to save that for another time. Let's just go beat the shit out of something. Right. Okay. So, see, I disappear. I've come up with all sorts of little cool things. Woo, boop, I'm back. So, if you are hanging out in the United States, you know there is this whole thing with Trump. And that is a sore subject. I mean, I swear, it's almost like Trump and 9/11 are the two of the worst subjects to discuss with people. Like, nobody wants to touch it. Because there's so many disagreements and people have so many strong opinions about it that you're guaranteed that if you talk about either one of those, you're going to offend someone. All right. So, you know, I was thinking about this the other day and I was just like, you know what? What if let's just forget about who is president, who's in office, who's in Congress, all this other bullshit. What is it that you actually want? You know, I mean, honestly, what is it that, you know, in this country that you want to see a change? Now, I know that there was a lot of people who were voting for Hillary or Bernie that wanted to see Obamacare continue to exist. But, okay, and you can look this up because this is actually a fact. Look up the OCB report, Office of Control or Budget or something like that. Anyway, it's what it is it is an independent company that analyzes the budget to see how much money we're spending, how effective it is. I'm probably saying that wrong, but the bottom line is I happen to have tuned in and actually watched this live, and then I went and grabbed a digital copy of a translation. It's not translation, it's a transcript of it. And what it came down to this, okay, and this is... And now, don't get me wrong, there's a lot of really good things that Obamacare did. I am not going to deny that, okay? But what it did, and this is the weird thing, and this is what some people have trouble comprehending, okay, is it wasn't... We had this whole thing with... oh, there you are. Ooh, he kicked my ass. He saw me there. Anyway, so, I better come back here. Oh, nailed it anyway. So what was happening is, if you have a job that is less than a certain number of hours, then you're considered part-time. And when you're a part-time employee and you get health insurance through that employer, then you get the government helps pay for a portion of your health insurance costs, and it's a pretty big portion. So, but and that only and that counts for that employer and that healthcare. So then what happens is, if you go to full-time employment with that employer, then the amount that the government pays decreases, but it decreases so significantly. And healthcare costs are so expensive, health insurance costs are so expensive, that what actually ends up happening is you end up only making very little more money working full time. And we are literally talking like maybe from going, for example, $200 a week to $215 a week. I mean, it is. I'd have to go look up the numbers, but it is something that is pretty close to that. So what's the point of getting a part-time job with that employer? But here's the loophole. If you go to another employer, okay, and you do not sign up for health insurance with that second employer because you already have health insurance, then the government is only looking at the employment for that one single thing, and you still get that same amount of dispensation from the government. So what that means is that you have a bunch of people out there who are getting part-time jobs. And keep in mind that a part-time, you know, average, oh, shit. Average full-time employment, most people look at it as 40 hours. But I think it's something like 25 or 30 hours or less per week are considered part-time. So you basically have someone who is working two jobs at 30 hours per week. And you have employers who previously had these full-time positions that now they had to eliminate the full-time positions and put in two part-time positions. And when they do that, it actually increases how much money they have to spend because every employee costs them extra money. I should have been able to. Anyway, so that's, you know, that's what you're talking about, increased costs for employers and less jobs available because, you know, there's more because a lot of these employers, what they were doing was they were like, okay, well, we're going to eliminate these full-time positions, period, and we're only going to hire one part-time employee and we're going to have them come in the middle of the shift. They're not going to hire other full-time because they don't want to spend the extra money. Fuck, nailed it. Oh. Damn, you nailed it from pretty far away. See, I told you, they were soft. If you hit them hard enough... There's another one over there somewhere. Where the hell is he? Oh, he got me first. So anyway, so, I mean, that's just one example. And, like, for example, me, you know, I'm not going to go into a lot of personal details, but I don't qualify. You know, and that's because the state's rights were stepped on, and the Supreme Court ruled that basically, well, there was a Supreme Court ruling having to do with stuff that the Obamacare plan said that they had to do, and the Supreme Court said it wasn't constitutional. So... because of that, I believe it or not, I didn't qualify for health insurance. I don't have any. A lot of people had to change health insurance. The actual cost of health care. Remember now, this was supposed to actually be called the Affordable Health Care Act. And it actually showed there. You can look it up on the internet. You can Google the crap out of it. You can go find your data, you know, and you're going to find a lot of stuff out there that actually talk about how the cost of health insurance has actually gone up, not down. So it actually didn't work. I mean, there's a lot of things that didn't work. But, okay, you did want people to be able to not, you know, for pre-existing conditions and to keep their health insurance for a longer period of time. And actually, there is something to have to do with the labels on the side of bottles. I mean, there's a lot of good things that were intelligent about it. I mean, that's clear. And I honestly think that based on the words that I've heard Trump say, and granted, he says shit that's just plain dumb and stupid, and he should set down the fucking smartphone and stop tweeting and stop Facebooking and, you know, and just focus on the job and keep his mouth shut, and he'd be a lot better off, you know. But I think that he sees that there's these good things and he wants to keep them. He wants to take the stuff about Obamacare that doesn't work and get rid of it. But you can't really do that. Obamacare is so ingrained with the way it put in there that you can't just fix it. You can't just, okay, we're going to change this, or we're going to change this, or we're going to change this. But what they can do, and this is what I think is the smart thing, is there are ways where you can have a bill that says that this particular bill is going to take over handling these aspects of Obamacare. So you can actually pass a bill that takes all the good stuff that we want to keep and say, okay, this is now this healthcare law. This is part of the responsible, this is, I would call it the Insurance Reformation Act or something, you know, the IRA, the Insurance Reform Act. okay? And I would have it specifically deal with the issues dealing with specifically with just insurance, because insurance is not really health care. So that's what I would do with that. So I'm getting all excited, and we're not playing tanks anymore. Is this the way things are going to go? So I'll try to give you something pretty to look at. So with that whole aspect of things there, ADD can't concentrate on more than one thing at a time. So I think that if they did that, if they set it up so they covered all these good elements, okay, with that has to do specifically with insurance, and basically said, okay, this will take over all of that, then they can turn around and go, okay, all these things that everybody's worried about that you're going to lose, that are bad about it, that they're taken care of. Like, we've made them permanent in this other law that's independent of health care. Like, we fixed this so that it's its own independent entity. And that gives people the ability, so if later down the line they want to modify it or adjust it or change it, or they want to repeal it because they think it sucks, then they don't destroy an entire system, which you did with the Affordable Health Care Act. All right? So I think that is the... I'm trying to decide what I want to do with this one. I think I'm going to go with here. That is the deal with that. I think that's a smart thing. And then you move on to the other aspects of the health care. You know, how can we provide health insurance for more people? You know, how can we actually do that? Because when you consider the fact that basically what you're talking about is health insurance isn't free, okay? You might not pay for it, but you're not getting it for free. Wait a minute. I gotta fix something here a minute. So you might not be paying for it, but you've got to get something for free. All right? You can't get it for free. Somebody has to pay for it. Somewhere that money has to come from somewhere. All right. So if that money isn't coming from somewhere, all right, where do you think that's coming from? Well, that's coming out of your taxes. If you have a job and you're working and you're making money and you're paying taxes, that's what your taxes are paying for. All right. And there are probably going to be people who need help, who really honestly have real health concerns, who can't work, who health insurance could really help, who, you know, if you saw them and you knew that they needed this help, that you would be like, and you had the money, you'd be like, yeah, sure, I'll help you. Ooh, pardon me. Ooh, that was wine. Woohoo! Anyway, you know, you would definitely, you know, want to help them. But at the other side of things, there are people out there who are just plain lazy and want to do nothing more than take advantage of federal programs. They don't want to work. They don't want to put any effort in it. They just want to do whatever they can to take as much from the federal government as they think that they can. And they don't. They know that, you know, they could probably have a job. They could probably go out and work. They could, you know, there's probably a lot of things, and you would be paying for them too. So you got to realize that, you know, where this money is coming from with this health care insurance. And I believe that Trump wants to make sure that that doesn't happen. All right. I think that's important. The other thing that a lot of people miss. Oh, there he is. I see him. Oh, would not fire. You can hear me hitting my trigger button. Here, hit my trigger. See, it's. Won't do it. All right, so let's go here. So anyway, so here I am, you know, talking about Trump and all that. You know, that's what you got to understand is that, you know, what if, you know, someone came to you, you know, and they said, hey, I've got this thing and it's better than Obamacare, and you looked at it and it actually is better than Obamacare. I mean, if you're going to replace something, wouldn't you want it to replace it with something better? You know, if I could tell you that. You know, a lot of people talked about single-payer systems. If I could say to you that this new system where you could walk into a hospital and if you don't have any health insurance, that you just submit your information, that information will be submitted to the federal government and you won't ever get a bill. That's it. It's all there is to it. It's all you have to worry about. I know he's really far away. I've actually hit someone that far before. Attack the main point. So, you know, just, I mean, think about that. You know, forget about whether it's Trump or not in office, but think about if that's what you want. Now, that being said, it's the same thing I said that when Obama was in office, that you can't hold the president responsible for every single law that's passed because it's up to Congress to pass the law. So for all you Trump supporters out there, okay, right now you have Democrats that are trying to put every single roadblock in the way. And even for some of you Democrats who, you know, are looking at Trump as better than the alternatives, you know, if you have to really think about whether or not his actual policies, not the bullshit that comes out of his mouth, but his actual actions, all right? Because honestly, I think Trump is just one of those people that he doesn't think before he talks, and that what he says isn't the way he meant it. You know, like he in his brain, that's not the way we hear it, it's not the way he hears it. In his brain, he's hearing something entirely different. Where the fuck did you come from? So, you know, just, I mean, I know that he could probably be better with the words that comes out of his mouth, but I think in his brain it actually sounds better. And, it you know, it sounds like the way we would expect it to sound to him. So, you know, just, I mean, it's not that it's good, but it's one of those things that, you know, just think about his actions. And if you really think that, you know, that some of the things he's doing is going to be better, is going to make this country better, whether it makes it great again or whether our country has always been great is irrelevant. It's whether or not it's good for you. If you think his policies are good for you, then you need to think about the secondary elections, the one that nobody pays attention to. Because the bottom line is, the more people that come out to vote, the more likely we're going to see change. You know, something is, I think I heard a statistic where something like less than 4% of the population actually votes. Who the fuck killed him? Where are you hiding? I'm gonna hide behind a rock. Capture a zone here. Now he's over there somewhere. There he is.
Allied forces have captured a zone.
Oh, bastard! You fucknut! I had him green. You saw that green little green arrow for like a split second, and then fuck. Oh, I'm having fun. So, you know, anyway, so you just show up, you know, participate in your local elections, even when it's not a presidential election. And I'm going to tell you this, this is a warning to all you Democrats out there, because Trump was a surprise, and you fucking know it, all right? And if he manages to rally the Republicans, okay, in all these states, and more Republicans turn out to vote than Democrats, then guess what's going to happen? We're going to see a Democrat-free Washington. That's right. And I honestly, and here's where I'm going to get a bunch of people are going to hate my ass and leave me nasty comments and shit, but the bottom line is, I think we need to get rid of the Democrats. I don't think they serve this country any good. I think we need a new team. I think we need a new political party, because I do think we need balance, but I think the Democrats are sore fucking losers. They're butthurt, and they're doing stupid shit, and they're not really doing what's good for the country. They're doing what they think is good for them, and that's the problem. And so I am all for kicking every single last Democrat out of Washington. I mean, I think that if we had a pure Republican Congress, then for once in our life, we would see what happens when this country actually does something positive, when something good actually comes together. You know, when something happens that's good for this country, regardless of whether you think so or not, and that's what we need. We need every single motherfucking Republican that exists that's registered to vote to come out and vote. All right? Speaking of voting, I bet you that if we offered amnesty to every single illegal alien that could prove that they voted in the previous election, we would solve the problem once and for all. We would find out exactly how many people illegally voted and who they actually voted for, and we would be done with it. That's what I think. Now, on to immigration. All right, now,
we need to put more pressure
go do a Wikipedia search. Look up immigration. All right, take a look at it. All right, look at the history. We have all from ever since we started really looking at the fact that we needed. Oh, motherfucker. You know, we needed to control our immigration. You know, when we did that, and we found out that we needed to, you know, figure out a way that we could, control our immigration, monitor it, where we realized that there's a possibility that people could come into our country that had no good intentions, that, you know, we could get criminals into our country, we began to change it. I mean, at one point it was the basic thing was you had to come into the country and you had to stay here for like 10 years, and as long as you were a good person, you became a citizen, and they've modified it and changed it and adjusted it over the years, you know, to where we have this system here. The system sucks. Honestly, legally speaking, the system really fucking sucks. It's horrible. It's nearly, I know this one guy, he's a great guy. He has a green card. He's done the legal route, and he's been in this country for 20 years, and he's still not a legal citizen. No wonder why people are sneaking across the border. It's nearly impossible to become a citizen. You know, and don't get me wrong, you know, there's nothing wrong with a little bit of vetting here and there, you know, because we don't want terrorists coming here. You know, I mean, you know, what if, you know, you had some guy move in next door to you and, like, you know, a couple of weeks later, you know, we had some people come to your house and they say, hey, by the way, we just wanted to warn you that the people next door to you are actual terrorists. And like, you know, they can present to you all the actual real proof that actually proved that they were terrorists. And they said to you, but because the federal government doesn't know all this, we're going to allow them to become a citizen. And that's basically what people aren't thinking about, that there are people who will come into this country, all right, and will come here to do harm. And I it's like I told one person, one life is worth, you know, a wall. If we can save just one life. So anyway, at this point, you know, we're talking about 56 minutes coming up on an hour long venture. Most people don't pay attention to me for a fucking hour. So I think at this point, what I'm going to do is I'm going to kill the game just like I did last time. In the other video, I actually figured out how to put those stupid little annotations on there. It's like, oh, it's not nearly as hard as I thought, but I didn't want to do them during the whatever. That's going to be the end of this. Let's see. There's this one. Hey, anyway. So, you know, visit drewthegeek.net if you want. If you don't, who cares? You can also look at kgraradio.com for your paranormal UFO alternative talk radio needs. I also handle jimmychurchradio.com with his podcast or his show Fade to Black. Those are all good shit to hang out. Have nothing to do with gaming, just so you know. So, anyway, looks like I have to adjust my keyframe, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, drewthegeek.net commercial.